Thousands of years ago, there were no paddy fields or plains in Goa, only the sea. The indigenous communities used their knowledge, skills, and labor to build bands and to restrict the seawater within the rivers and to create vast expanses of fertile land. Our Kharvi, Pagi, and other fishing communities could now use the manchio and augurs to cultivate fish. They also used futani, katali, kobule, and pagels to fish in the rivers. Our indigenous communities collectively cultivate rice, coconut, vegetables, and many other things in these fertile lands. Every village is self-sufficient for fish, curry, and rice thanks to our rivers. The rivers sustain not just humans, but also rich biodiversity, such as fish, clams, crabs, mangroves, otters, crocodiles, birds, and various other forms of life. These living rivers look after man just as man looks after the rivers in a harmonious relationship. But today, this harmony is under a grave threat. The government wants to nationalize the six main rivers of Goa: Zuari, Mandavi, Kumbharsua, Shapora, Mapsa, and Sal. What is this nationalization of rivers? It is a forced acquisition of our rivers and our lands to be handed over to private companies. The rivers, which have been ours forever, will now be lost for the first time in history. The private companies will be the new masters, and our people and these rivers their slaves. The only agenda of these private companies is to transport coal through our rivers and our villages. Massive steel factories are planned at Bellary in Karnataka, for which they are prepared to completely destroy our Goa. Instead of living rivers, we will now have lifeless shipping channels. Instead of bands and mangroves, we will have concrete walls and jetties. Instead of paddy fields and khazans, we will have huge mountains of coal. Our village roads will be used by thousands of coal trucks, and our villages will be more polluted than Vasco is today. Instead of schools and colleges, we will now need only hospitals and cemeteries. Our very existence is under threat. Our future generations will have nothing to survive upon. So, it is very important for each one of us to stand and be counted, to protect our rivers and our rights.